Hello students, how are you? I think your preparation is doing very well. Thanks for watching my last video based upon the molarity and relationship between the molarity and molarity. Today I came to explain about the cathode rays discharge tube experiment or cathode rays tube experiment discovery of the electrons. In this video I am going to discuss about the who named the electron, who discovered the electron, what is meant by discharge tube experiments. In way cathode rays are originated from the gas molecules or the metal, why we have to take the low pressure while performing the discharge tube experiment. So all these points I am going to discussing in this video. So coming to the topic, Julius Flucker and William Crookes, these are the two scientists who done the experiment electricity passed through the gas. These two scientists, they performed the experiment. So in this performed experiment, they used the one tube that is called as a discharge tube. A discharge in the sense some charge is originated from them, charge is produced from this, that is called as a discharge tube. What is the discharge tube experiment? Discharge tube experiment is nothing but the simple one glass tube fitted with the two electrodes, metal electrodes fitted with the two metal electrodes. Why we have to take the metal electrode in the sense, already we know that metals are the good conductors of the heat and electricity, that we know. And next one, it is having the some vacuum pump. What is the use of the vacuum pump? So while doing the experiment without vacuum pump, without vacuum, what will happen? Definitely some atmospheric water, this is called as a water will be there, air will be there. If you not become a vacuum, what will happen? While doing the experiment, some rays or whatever the rays is there, cathode rays or anyway cathode rays or anode rays, whatever it may be, they will collide with the air and water present inside the tube automatically. We cannot see collisions will happen, we cannot see the clear picture, we cannot see. That's why we have to use the vacuum pump to adjust the vacuums completely. Whenever we are doing the experiment, we have to remove the air, we have to remove the water molecule, we have to remove completely. And here we have to take the gas at the lower pressure, we have to take, that is very mandatory, we have to take the gas at the lower pressure only we have to take. Why we have to take the gas at the lower pressure? So already we know that ideal gas equation PV is equal nRT. So at a constant volume, at a constant temperature, what will happen? Pressure is directly proportional to the N. So what will happen? That means whenever we are increasing the pressure, number of the molecules will be increased. Whenever the number of the molecules increases, they are collided with the cathode rays, automatically they will obstruct the, they will restrict the path of the cathode rays. That's why we are not using the high pressure, we are not using, that's why we are using the low pressure, we are using the low pressure. So here what will happen? William Crookes and Julius Flucker performed the cathode rays experiment. So they are having the lower pressure, nothing but 10 to the power of minus 4. So they are applied, they are connected to the two electrodes to the batteries, they are connected. That means cathode and anode, negative end is connected to the positive end, positive end is connected to the negative end. So what will happen? They applied the high electrical voltage, they applied the high electrical voltage. Almost like 10,000 electric volt, they are applied the 10,000 electrical volt. What will happen whenever they are applied the electric? So whenever they are applying the electrical volt across the tube, so that cathode and anode get started heating, the metals get started heating, the electrodes get started heating. Whenever they get started heating, so some rays are originated from the cathodes, some rays are originated from the cathode, they are traveling towards the anode. That means here what will happen? Already we know that similar charges are repelled with each other and opposite charges are attracted with each other. So here that whatever the rays are there, rays are traveling towards the anode, traveling towards the anode in the sense the charges having the opposite charge of the, in comparison to the anode, that's why they are attracted towards the anode, they are attracted. And one more thing is they are originated from the cathode, that's why here it is called as a cathode rays, that's why we are using called as a cathode rays, we are, it is called as a cathode rays. So what are the properties? So after doing this experiment, William Crookes, J.J. Thomson and Julius Flucker studied the properties of the cathode rays. The first property is cathode rays are traveling in a straight line, they are traveling in a straight line they are traveling. They are originated from the cathode, they are traveling in a straight line towards the anode, they are traveling in a straight line. So next property is there, whenever these rays are traveling, the cathode rays are traveling towards the anode, if you place any metal object, what will happen? They will cast shadow of the metal object behind the anode. Here anode will be there behind the anode. This is a very similar like if you go for the theater, what will happen when the projector is coming, when they started on the projector, so if anyone is standing, automatically we will see their shadow on the screen. We will see similar way it is happen. So next one, this is the second property. Third property is they will produce the fluorescent screen when they touch the glass wall. Glass wall having the screen like zinc sulfide. So what will happen here, we will make one screen because we want to know whether the rays are coming or not. So this is made up of a zinc sulfide. We are making up a mega, there is a fluorescent screen. When they are striking, what will happen? They will produce some glow wave. That is indicators the rays are passing through the towards the anode. Next one, what will happen? If you place any wheel, when their rays are traveling, the wheel is rotated. The wheel is started rotating. That's indicated what? Whenever the wheel is started rotating, it indicated that they are having some kinetic energy. They are having the kinetic energy, that's why wheel is rotated. Next one is they will ionize the gases. How can you win in the other? We have taken the gases. So whenever the cathode rays are traveling, so the some gas particles are there. So whenever the cathode rays are there, they will become ionized. That means what will happen? They will become the positive, they will become the negative. So the cathode rays ionize the gas atoms, gas particle, into positive particles and negative particles. These positive particles will go towards the cathode. These negative particles along with the cathode rays, they are traveling towards the positive. That means what happened? This kinetic energy is converted into heat energy. So this is the one point. And next point, what will happen if you apply the electrical magnetic field when it comes to the different charges? So already we know that these are traveling towards the anode in a straight line, they are traveling. So in the path, if I placed the two different charged electric field, that means one is positive, one is negative, what will happen? Already we know that whenever the path, if I placed the charged plate, they are deflected. That means they are not traveling in a straight line, they are not traveling. So they are get deflected like this, they are traveling deflected. So what will happen? They are deflected towards the positive end. That means what? They are attracted towards the positive end. They are not going the negative end. So already we saw the last video, molarity and molality. So which video you like more, please comment in the comment section. And next property is there. If you place the magnetic field. Two magnets you have to take. Whenever the traveling the cathode rays, if you take the magnet, they are also deflected. Deflection will start. This means if you apply the electric field and a magnetic field, they are started. So these are the some properties. And whenever the what will happen, these cathode rays passes through the some high atomic mass metal, what will happen? Some short wavelength particles are originated, that is called as a X-rays. They ionize the gas particle, they affected the photoelectric field. So all these properties studied by the J.J. Thomson named these cathode rays, he named it as a negatron, he's named it. So later the scientist name is called as a Stoney, he named the negatron into electron. It changes the electron into electron. So J.J. Thomson, by the deflection of the electrical and magnetic field, so he studied the specific charge, that is called as a E by M ratio. Already I made a E by M ratio of the proton, E by M ratio of the alpha particle, E by M ratio of the electrons. Everything I made a one video, I will keep in a place in the iCard, once see there. So E by M ratio of the electron, so that is minus 1.7588 into 10 to the power of 8 coulomb per gram. So these are the properties of the cathode rays. So next video I will make on some questions I will make in that videos also I will mention some level 1, level 2, level 3, level 5, like these questions I will mention. So overall in this video, why we have to use the low pressure, why we have to use, if you know the, already I said in this video, if you know the answer, please comment in the comment section. Who named the electron, that also you have to name it, mention in the comment section. What is the J.J. Thomson named the cathode rays, how to do. So what will what will happen if you apply the different magnetic field, electric field, what will happen the cathode rays, that also we have to do the comment in the comment section. And E by M ratio of the electron also you have to do the comment in the comment sections. So thank you for watching my videos.